in Perea, but actually out here in the wonderful city of Gardena. All the old folks call me the Perea boy. This is where I grew up at right here. I'm 136 in Hoover. In Gardena, you got the 110 freeway right there. Actually, that shit there used to be like a chain link fence. It's the rocks around cars and shit. I wasn't born and raised in North County, so it's good. It's good. Let's go for a walk and show you the actual house that I grew up in. It's still ugly as fuck. This is the crib right here where it all started. 719 West 136th Street, Hoover and Menlo. See, that's where it is. She influences for hip hop for me. Of course, East Coast hip hop, major influence. You know, like EPMD, Big Daddy Kane, of course. Of course, gotta have the West Coast stuff. I'm talking Too Short, classic Ice Cube, definitely. You know, back Death Certificate, major influence on how I you know, write my lyrics and come up with concepts. But so much good classic hip hop music that's just instrumental in everything I do. I think hip hop is in a state right now. It's starting to come back around, but it's just gonna take a little more effort on the artists that want to take it to that level where it once was, with the creativity and the concepts. So I mean, until everyone steps their game up, you know, I'm talking, you know, worldwide, not just West Coast. I'm talking everybody. Everyone's kind of gotten relaxed as far as hip hop goes. They think they can just put a little catchy hook out and do a little dance and it's a rap. But that stuff is long gone. You know, you actually have to have something worth talking about. So I mean, matter of time, we'll just see. You know, I mean, hip hop is a culture. You know, it's a way of life. It's not something you just decide to do. So we're here in Santa Ana right now, off of Bristol Civic Center. We're here at Ghetto Records. Unfortunately, it's closed down. It's been kind of like a staple in the hip hop community in Orange County. And God, I've been coming here since I was, you know, 14 years old. Supporting everybody out here. So if you're doing hip hop and you're out here in Orange County and even LA, everyone knows about Ghetto Records. It's kind of a spot to be at. You can see they got the poster, you know, they got me up. You know, they stay supporting me. You know, it's too bad that the spot isn't how it used to be, you know, because the music industry is so fucked up. Let's go inside, check it out. I'm gonna introduce y'all to my guy Hank here at Electronic Warehouse. He holds me down, he keeps it going for me. You know, you gotta keep your CDs in the public, you know what I'm saying? And what better place to do it than at a stereo shop, right?
Hey, what's up, man? How you doing?
Chilling. The homie Hank right here, man, holds it down, Electronic Warehouse. Yeah. Let him know what's going on, man.
Yeah, it's 1014 North Harbor Boulevard, Santa Ana. Come hit me up, mention that, I'm gonna hook you up, hip you right out.
You see what it is? You see the poster? Here we go. You know what I'm saying? See the mixtape? See? Shout out to my guy, the Hitman, out of Dallas, Texas, Swerve Radio. Man, they fuck with me heavy, you know? Even got my album, Jump Off, Addicted to the Grind. Got Hoopla LRT Universal. Come on, man, they keep me laced up here all day. The flyers, come on. I mean, they keep me riding here, man. We always bring it to the people. Here we are down in South County, 949, city of Lake Forest, El Toro, whatever you want to call it, same shit. Yeah, so this is where it all goes down. You know, you got Landis View neighborhood right here. Kind of like the older part of this area, you know, all the way from Gardena, Santa Ana, down here.
My homie been out here doing this thing for a hot minute, you know? A lot of good quality music that came out this way, you know what I'm saying, myself included. And it's just one of the brothers out here that's been doing it, you know what I'm saying? Straight, long, strong run, you feel me? And you know, it's what it is. My homie right there, Epidemic, you know what I'm saying? We get it in the studio. Live show, I mean, you know, we fathers at the same time, you know what I'm saying? So it's all real. Trying to feed our families with this music shit and still stay creative and bring that dope music out at the same time. So no funny business here, it's all real. And I just wanted to say what's up to my dude Epidemic on this documentary that he's doing. And that's what it is, Eliso Black, Cuatro Uno Tres, motherfucking nine for nicest, nigga, believe it.
Yeah, you know, me and my boy Epidemic, you know, we had some cool, you know, episodes. My boy is a real useful cat, so, you know, I can remember once upon a time, man, he took me out to this conference thing, man, you know what I mean? I had never been to one of these industry conferences, you know what I mean? It was really, you know, something to focus on the rapper. You know, most conferences I've been to was, you know, really to focus on going to see a show or something like that. But anyway, we went to the conference, and, you know, I gained so much information that day, man. I went home feeling like a little kid, like, man, this is my first day rapping. You know what I mean? I didn't know half of the stuff I knew that day over 20 years of being in the industry. So, you know, I say that to say that, you know, if you're going to have a friend in this industry, make sure your friends can contribute to what you're trying to do. You know what I mean? Keep people around that got your best interests at heart. You know what I mean? And that's what I can say about my loved one, Ep. You know what I mean? He always had my best interests at heart. So keep doing what you're doing, Ep. You know what I mean? You know I got your back 101. I'm going to fuck somebody up for you. So, you know, I already know how we do it. West Coast, baby.
It's Compton OG, you know what I mean? We got the most definite documentary going, you know what I'm saying, for my bro, Epidemic. But it's Compton OG, homie. You know, I support Ep to the fullest. That's one dude out here, homie, that keep it 100 with everybody, no matter your race or none of that. Ep 100, you know what I'm saying? And plus, you know, Ep grew up in the hood, so a lot of cats knock and whatnot, but you know what I'm saying? Fuck y'all. You know, any motherfucker hating on him, homie. You know what I'm saying? He got a movement going. I'm supporting that, homie. And I'm a factor out here in these motherfucking streets. So, you know what I'm saying? None of this shit we fucking with is no acting shit. So a lot of you cats, man, you got to start watching what you say about people. Because if you don't know a person personally, homie, don't speak on them. Fuck what you heard. Fuck what you hear. You know what I'm saying? Go out facts. I go out facts, homie. And a motherfucking fact from me, Compton OG, homie, Don Sizzle, Epidemic 100 in my books, homie, and anything got against that, let's go to war, for real, holla at me. I ain't hard to find. Westside Compton, bitch.